so many trees, so many different plants, so many ferns between two ferns. It's Niamh. I'm your science communicator in residence for the Abbey Leaks Climate Action Plan, and I'm here in the Abbey Leaks bog, which is stunning. I'd like to know a little bit more about biodiversity though, you know? What does that mean and how can we do something to benefit it? I think I might know. There's somebody here who might be able to help me, and her name is Fiona. I'm gonna go and find her.
Help! Niamh, are you all right?
Oh, Fiona, thank you so much. I don't know what I'm looking at, Fiona. What am I looking at?
Okay, well, we just have some information about the species that you'll find on Abbey Leaks Bog here. So
all of these
birds,
are here.
Plants, animals, little animals. We've got lots of lovely butterflies, moths, lots of different insects. So,
and how is biodiversity going in general?
In general, unfortunately, we're in the middle of a biodiversity crisis.
Another one.
I suppose we have the bigger climate change picture, and the biodiversity crisis is a very big part of that. And in Ireland, it's something that we can see happening in front of us. We're losing species. The numbers of species are going down. People are familiar with things like, you know, the lovely curlew, a beautiful bird that people would have found very common in the not too distant past, but we're down to our last couple of hundred pairs. And that's to do with changes in habitats. Areas that were wet before are getting drained and drying out, and, you know, these kind of birds need those habitats to nest.
What can we do? Who just like...
Well, there's definitely things that we can do. We can maybe educate ourselves a bit. There's lots of information out there to be had. But some simple things that people can do. Recently, there's been a lot of work done looking at pollinator species in Ireland. So pollinators that a lot of people know would be the butterflies, but also our bees. You know, we have one honeybee species, but we've got over 20 bumblebee species and over 70 solitary bee species. And these are all really important because they pollinate flowers and plants that we want, because we want apples, we want strawberries, you know, we need the fruit. So what we can do is, the numbers of our pollinators in Ireland have been decreasing hugely in recent years because, again, the loss of habitat and loss of food. So the pollinators love to eat pollen, hence their name. Part of their name.
Yeah.
And they need lots of flowers and plants where they can get all that nice pollen, and we have not been helping them because we have been clearing away areas of wildflowers where they would have got lots of pollen. But also we've changed the way we garden, and we're using plants that are, you know, lovely and bright in the summertime, the pelargoniums and the begonias and the petunias, but unfortunately they don't have much pollen because they've been so highly bred for color, etc. So what we can do is just change some of the things that we're planting. And we can go back to some of the lovely old-fashioned species like lavenders, the lovely hardy geraniums, plants that, herbaceous perennial plants that flower for months and months and months and come back every year. So if we can do that, or we can have little boxes, window boxes at home, fill them with herbs. Herbs are great for pollinators, and then we also get to eat the herbs as well. So there's a terrific website, pollinators.ie.
Pollinators.ie.
And there's all sorts of information on that. They'll be able to find all sorts of plant lists and lots of little small projects that you could do in your garden at home.
Okay, brilliant. So thanks, Fiona. Okay. Can I ask you something else? Can you help me get out of here?
Yeah, sure.
Because I think I'm lost. Is it this way or this
no
way?
Problem.
Okay, this way.